Stay tuned for Fracking Mondays here on WBAI.
On the programme tonight, we'll examine what steps some elected officials are taking to deal with fracking. Doug, if we could start with you while we connect some of the other city council members. You've been a lawmaker since 2004. Pittsburg was the first city in Pennsylvania and the country to pass an ordinance on November the 16th to ban hydraulic fracturing within the city limits. How did you first become aware of hydraulic fracturing for natural gas, and what gave you concern that you wanted to make sure the city of Pittsburg, which sits on top of the Marcellus Shale, was protected?
We found out somewhere in 2002 and 2003 that Pennsylvania was sitting on a very large gas reserve, a super giant gas field. And so when we heard about the shale deposit, nobody that I know of from a public policy view really understood what was involved in it. However, the industry did, and obviously looking back now, they were preparing all along. In 05, you know, the field discovered in 03, in 05, they get the Halliburton exemptions passed through with the energy bill that was largely crafted by Dick Cheney and his cohort, mostly from the industry. Were kind of wrote their own script about what they're going to do. They came into Pennsylvania then and challenged local counties, which were levying extraction taxes on the old gas wells, and challenged it in the court of law, and lo and behold, guess what? There was never any enabling legislation from the state for the counties to do this, so that tax was removed, and that was done in 06. And so in 07 and 08 and 09, they began to lease up, and that's when those people came to me and said, what's going on? There was subsequently a community meeting out there, and we had someone from Clean Water Action, someone from Penn State, and then there was an attorney from Washington County just south of Pittsburgh that represented only landowners in these transactions, and he was pointing out all the pitfalls and whatnot. You know, he made it very clear. He says, look, I'm all for drilling. I just want to make sure you're protected because that's where I make my money. But the more and more we looked in this, the more we began to understand hydraulic fracturing, the process that we've used. This is not your grandpap hydraulic fracturing. Tom Ridge will be out there. Oh, we've been doing this for 60 years. No, they have not. That's a lie. They've been doing this. They began to do on the scale what they're talking about, this hydrofracking of shale gas in a big way. And, of course, Halliburton has the proprietary formula on most of the fluids that are employed in this, and it basically has a lot of customers in Pennsylvania to do this fracking. And that's kind of the genesis of how it got here. Once it got here, the more we began to understand it, the fact of the impacts on the environment, the impacts on the health. What do you do? How do you dispose of the slick water, the return fluids that come back, not only with the stuff they put in it, but radionuclides, radioactive material, strontium, bromides, which interact with disinfectants that create chlorofluoromethane in the water itself, which is a known carcinogen and linked to bladder cancer. All these things are coming on. I said, well, and then I add to that my first responders have no means, no training, and are ill-equipped to deal with a well blowout, which also happened. We had 4 blowouts within 60 miles of the city within a 5-week span last year. Bradford County, only last month, they had a blowout, and for nearly 2 days, whatever they put into the ground was spewing all over the place, along with methane gas into the air and into the surrounding environment, essentially rendering the surface water there useless to the farmers that had leached the land. So why would I, as an elected official, embrace this without the adequate knowledge of what it is and what those impacts are? And I took an oath to uphold the health, welfare, and public safety of those whom I represent. And these institutions of government should be serving the public, and what they do are doing in this case by and large, are serving the interests of the corporate community, get what they can get, and leave us stuck with the impact.